Hey, sports card investor and collector friends. Hope everyone's having a great Sunday. It's football Sunday. Do you have your fantasy football lineup all ready to go? I am not ready. I have Derrick Henry, who plays for the Titans, who I think that their game got moved back. Honestly, I've been trying to track which games are happening, which games are not. I saw that a New England Patriots coach, I think, tested positive, so that game might be in jeopardy. So much going on in football. It's wild. I'm wondering if, you know, I'm hopeful that my Saints are playing the Chargers tomorrow night. I hope that everything is good to go on that front. So, but today, guys, we are going to be talking about some wild hobby news, sports card hobby news that's been going on lately. Some interesting sales and, you know, just some interesting things going on in the hobby I wanted to discuss with you all. So let me know kind of your thoughts in the comments. Like always, this is a discussion channel, open forum. I really like to get into the comments and kind of go back and forth and talk with you all too and kind of get your feedback so I can learn from you all. So anyway, let's go ahead and dive into it. First off, we have recently retired rapper Logic recently purchased a Pokemon Charizard Holo First Edition PSA 10 for $220,000 in an iconic auction sale. So this is, I believe that this is the largest Pokemon sale on record. I could be wrong on that. I'm not a huge Pokemon person. I didn't collect as a kid. I was an 80s kid, whereas Pokemon was more kind of the 90s era. My little brother actually was into Pokemon and Pokemon cards. So a little bit after my time, but it seems like that nostalgia fire is happening in the hobby today, because man, Pokemon is lit, as the kids would say. And I'm probably, you know, 6 months behind. I'm sure that's not even a thing anymore. Lit is probably already passed and gone. Now it's something else. Fire. It's fire, right? I think it's hilarious when I hear, you know, 60-year-olds. When my dad says fire, it makes me laugh. He doesn't actually say fire. I'm joking. All right. So anyway, huge, huge Pokemon sale. You know, is this going to continue? One thing I wanted to discuss, and I've heard this kind of going around, I've heard this phrase a lot. It's an economic term in a sense. A rising tide lifts all boats. And I understand the logic behind this theory. And in some ways, I think that it can be true. I think that, though, we have to be careful that we don't think of this as gospel, in the sense that if we have a huge, huge Pokemon sale for a very, very rare Pokemon card, that means that all the other Pokemon cards that are similar in rarity or less are going to rise with that sale, because that's just not necessarily true at all. I mean, I think the one thing that we have to keep in mind is that each player, each card, each set has its own supply and demand curve that it's working with. So just because something that is very, very rare that is similar to what we might have doesn't necessarily mean that all of those lower price cards that are more affordable, that they are going to rise in price. It doesn't necessarily mean that. You know, and I'm going to kind of come back. I'm going to come full circle on this. In Sports Cards Daily, or Sports Collectors Daily, reported that Rally Road, which Rally is a company, it's a fractional shares of Collectibles company, and I've done a video on them before, as well as Collectible, the Collectible app, and they do something similar. But Rally recently raised $17 million in cash from investors, with one of the investors being a Reddit co-founder, Alexis Ohanian. I'm probably saying his name wrong, but that's a big time, you know, big time players getting into collectibles. And Rally has made it to where, kind of like, you know, the Robin Hood of collectibles, to where you can buy fractional shares of collectibles. So if you can't afford that $1 million card, you can buy a $20 share of it, in a sense. And these fractional shares it's been a huge talking point in the hobby recently, as to do people like it? Do they not like it? Is it the future? Or is it a fad? You know, and it's a really good debate. I've been watching a lot of hobby talk on it. I really enjoy kind of listening to different people's perspectives on fractional shares. It's not something I've gotten into on the stock market side. I don't have a Robinhood account. Typically just buy shares, just whole shares, if I'm going to buy something. Or, you know, it's index funds or something like that. You know, so this is a very interesting topic for me. The one big thing that sticks out for me, it's kind of the what would hold me back from getting in on something like this. And it's not necessarily, you know, I think the companies, from what it looks like, you know, the SEC is regulating it. It looks like they have kind of buttoned the, you know, buttoned everything up, and it looks to be legitimate as far as just a business venture goes. Of course, I don't know all the ins and outs. I haven't read the prospectus. I haven't, you know, I haven't dug deep into all of the, into any of these companies. Just kind of looked at the surface of it. But it does look like, you know, they've kind of done it the right way, so to speak, to get everything up and running. The issue that I have, or the sticking point that is kind of just holding me back, is the initial valuation of the card. So it's the thing of, you know, with these collectibles, they're rare. There's, you know, there are very few sales. The supply part of a lot of these cards is unknown to some degree, to where you can have, if you have 10 of a card, let's just say, that are in existence that you know of, and an 11th pops up, or 10 more pop up out of nowhere, it greatly impacts the price of that card. Because this is, you know, you're using mathematical equations to come up with, okay, this card's worth $1 million based on the price of this one and this one and maybe a comp over here. That's a tricky, tricky game. It's very, very difficult. It's not an exact science. And especially with sports cards being so popular right now, I feel like these valuations, they could be high. Now look, the people that are getting in on this, they don't have that feeling. They must feel that, hey, I'm getting in low. And it depends on kind of your thinking on this as to, with these high-end collectibles, is, you know, is this the beginning? Is this just the beginning of, look, instead of fine art, instead of kind of, you know, very expensive other sorts of things, is that moving into sports cards and sports memorabilia? And the answer could very well be yes. I think that that's going to be just such a very interesting talking point and, you know, research study over the next 10 years, 20 years, 30 years to see where that market goes. I'm very, very interested in it. Obviously, I'm huge into collectibles. I love the stuff. I love hearing kind of the nostalgia that drives these buys. And, you know, so I'm all for, you know, advancing it. It's just, you know, I'm curious to see just as a society if we move more towards collectibles. Because as it sits right now, collectibles are not considered as a mainstream investment. You know, when you go and you put money into mutual funds, as far as I know, I don't have an option to go to a collectibles fund. And that's, I guess that's kind of what Rally and Collectible have been born out of, I guess, to a certain degree. It's not an index fund, but it's a way to invest in shares of collectibles. So it's interesting. Is it going to catch fire? Is this going to be the new thing? Or is this just kind of a flash in the pan type deal? And that's what I'm interested in following and just kind of seeing. Now, going back to a rising tide lifts all boats, then my question goes to, look, if fractional shares becomes a thing, becomes very popular, then instead of, you know, that theory, instead of people buying, you know, a lesser Michael Jordan card as opposed to the PSA 10 86 Fleer, then instead of buying that lesser Jordan card, do they just buy a fractional share of the Jordan card that they covet? You know, if it's that PSA 10 86 Fleer, if they want to say, hey, I want a piece of that, and that's awesome, and that makes me happy inside, you know, maybe they do that. Maybe they buy an extensive amount of shares in that as opposed to buying, you know, a different Michael Jordan card that might be more in their price point. These are just all talking points. I think that it's very interesting to kind of, you know, debate it and to hear other people's thoughts on it. Like I said, I have not gotten into fractional shares. I'm in wait and see mode on it. I'm going to wait and see kind of what happens over the next probably 12 to 18 months with fractional shares and collectibles and just see how it grows. I'll tell you what though, Rally Road, and so I know Collectible is more focused on sports cards right now, but Rally Road has all sorts of different things. So if you're into kind of these alternative investments, you know, I think they've got, you know, I know they've got like classic cars, there's fine wines, there's all these different things that are out there. And I think it's at least a cool kind of, it's a cool thing to check out anyway. You know, whether or not you put money into any one given thing, I think it's really, really interesting. And it's something that I want to follow. So guys, let me know what you think about this. I also should bring up too that there is a Sports Collectors Daily also reported that Golden Auctions is going to offer a T206 Honus Wagner and a PSA 1. So not in very good condition at all, but it doesn't really matter because these are so rare. I think there's less than 50 of these T206 Honus Wagners that are known to be in existence or that were ever printed. You know, so it's an extremely rare, very important card. But back in 2004, it sold for just over $100,000. And this one is expected to reach $1 million. Now, whoever came up with that, it's going to expected to reach $1 million. We don't know, but is it, you know, is Rally or Collectible looking to buy one of these cards? Is it, you know, so this adds a whole new spectrum to high-end sports cards and sports memorabilia. It's interesting. It's fun to follow. So guys, let me know what you think on this. Tell me about your theory on, a rising tide raises all boats, because I hear it talked about a lot, but I just think that it's good to debate it. It's good to debate because it's not a given. It's not set in stone that that is the case. It's really case by case, card by card, player by player, in my opinion. Let me know what you think. Guys, I appreciate you checking in, and please subscribe if you haven't already. If you haven't, what are you waiting for? Guys, we have the paintings. We've got the videos daily. Jump on board. Take care, guys. Thank you.